possible. This is a deficiency in me. He say, Alastu ana min safiti abi a'rafu hasan al-kalam wa qabihuhu. He say, am I not the individual that is the best from my father's side? That meaning from those who know the language of his parents. Now he's bragging about what? The knowledge of the language. He say, and I know when the words are correct and when the words are not correct. I know this. I know it. The minute I hear it, I can pinpoint it. بالضبط, say that this word is not correct. It should be replaced with this word. So the line of poetry, the rhyme, right, as we say, will be correct. Right? Or as the lyric can be correct. So he mentioned, he say, إذن فمن العجز. So therefore, if I'm equipped with all of this, what will be the deficit? What will prevent me from listening to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He say, أن أبقى على كلام قريش. Then why would I still hold on to the statement of the Quraysh? That told me what? Do not listen to him. I'm well equipped in Arabic. I know the Arabic language. So he mentioned, ولكن سألقي القطن الذي في أذني. So therefore he said, I decided to remove the plugs that I had in my ears. He said, وأسمع كلامه. To hear the statement of the messenger, meaning what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was reciting. فإذا كان حقا أتبعه. If it is the truth, I will follow it. Allahu Akbar. So if it is the truth, I will follow it. I'm well equipped. Why would I listen to hold on to the statement of the Quraysh? They don't know Arabic more than I do. And I'm from the best among my father lineage in Arabic. If I hear a word that is right, I will know it. بالضبط. If I know when it is wrong, I will know it. Right? So he say, I decided to remove the current plugs or the ear plugs. If and to listen to his statements. فإن كان حقا أتبعوه. If he is speaking the truth, I will just follow him. وإن كان باطلا تركته. But if he is talking about falsehood, rubbish, then I will leave him. I will abandon him. I will stay away from him. So therefore, فألقي القطون, and I remove the plugs. فسمع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. معذر فألقى. He removed the plugs. فسمع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. وسمع منه بعد قراءته. فعرف أنه حق. He heard what the messenger was reading, and he knew immediately that what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying was the truth. وَأَنَّمَا يَقُولُهُ حَقٌّ. And he knew what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying was the truth. So therefore he فَعَرَفْتُ أَنَّهُ حَقٌّ. I knew that this was the truth. I knew this was the truth. وَأَنَا مَعْذِرًا. وَأَنَّمَا يَقُولُهُ حَقٌّ. And I knew what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying was the truth. He said, right away, فَأَتَّبِعُهُ, I follow him. Meaning, I follow him إِلَى بَيْتِهِ, I follow him to his house. وَسَمِعَ مِنْهُ, and I listen to him more. وَقَرَأَ عَلَيْهِ الْقُرْآنِ, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم read to him more of the Quran. فَأَسْلَمَ وَعَادَ إِلَى بَلَدِهِ. He accepted Islam, and he went to his village or his country or his place of dwelling. فَلَمَّا قَدِمَ, when he arrived in his place, جَاءَ أَبُوهُ لِيُسَلَّمَ عَلَيْهِ. His father came to him to greet him. فَقَالَ لَهُ إِلَيْكَ عَنِّي. He told his father, stay away from me. فَلَسْتُ مِنْكَ وَلَسْتَ مِنِّي. You are not from me, and I'm not from you. Wallahi, sometimes we are not asked to tell this to our fathers. We only ask to follow the sunnah. We are not asked to say this to our fathers and our mothers. We only ask to hold on to the ground, to our ground, to the religion. And this shows you that the people today, barakallahu feekum, they are leaving al-aqs, the Muslims. As it, yani balaghani, that when people see certain people, when they rush to them, they want to assimilate themselves to individuals, while they should be running away from these individuals. And I can give you a concrete example. When an individual like these musicians or these rappers, when people see them, Muslims see them, and they wanna jump to them, they wanna magnify them, they wanna venerate them. Why we should ignore them? Why we should act like they don't even exist? Why we should show them that you are not from those who are the cream of the pie? You are not somebody that nobody should be paying mind to. But the Muslim, they want to gravitate towards this in likes of these individuals. But look, Tufail ibn Amr ibn Adawsi, he said his father, Ilayka anni, stay away from me. I am not, he said, falastu minka, then I am not from you. Walasta minni, and you are not from me. So what is this called in Al-Islam? What is this called? Huh? Ahsanta. If you didn't make the coffee, I would have given you a microphone. Al-wala'u wal-bara. Association and disassociation. Wallahi. If we claim in the sunnah, if we claim in salafiyya, and yet we don't have al-wala'u wal-bara, know that our salafiyya is deficient. Know that we have not reached the true level of salafiyya. لا بد بالولاء والبراء. It must have the association and the disassociation. It is not because Adam is Mandingo, Keva is Mandingo, they have a group on the corner, huh? The Mandingo corner. It is not so, ayyuhal ikhwa, wallahi. It is not me and Mustafa, we have the same name, which is the case, right? That we're going to have like a jai corner. La wakallah wallahi. It is not, this is something that we must open our eyes into. Having al-wala'u wal-bara. Look, Tufail, he declared his father after he accepted Islam that he knew that you and I don't have none in common, man. What do we have in common? And this is why sometimes to stand on your ground is important. But look at this. He mentioned, قَالَ لَهُ أَبُوهُ. Now his father didn't give up, right? His father told him, لِمَاذَا لَا يَا بُنَيَّ. What makes you say this statement, O you, my son? قَالَ إِنِّي تَابَعْتُ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَتَرَكْتُ دِينِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ وَعِبَادَةُ الْأَوْثَانِ. He say, for indeed, I am now one of those who follow Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and I have abandoned the religion of the jahiliyyah, and likewise worshiping the idols. I abandoned those. فَقَالَ, and his father told him, dini dinuka, that my religion now, it is your religion, my son. My religion is your religion. Meaning what? The father accepted Islam. He said, فَكَيْفَ يُسْلَمْ فَأَسْلَمَ. Tell me, how do I become a Muslim? I'm going to be a Muslim right now. This is why, to show, sometimes, wallahi, it is only standing on your grounds. What change is in the hands of Allah. It is only what changes in the hands of Allah. What is to be done is stand on your ground. Defend your belief. That's all it is. But amma an-natija, it is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But defend your position. Defend your religion. Defend your belief system. Because without the doubt, the people, they will find any way possible to take you out from the truth. Right? من الحق من النور إلى الظلمات. It's what the people want to do to you. ليخرجك من النور إلى الظلمات. This is what the people want to do. So therefore, he asked his father, say, ديني دينك. My deen is your deen, or you my son. He say, فعلمه أو فعلمه نعم. فنمعذره. He say, فعلمه كيف يسلم فأسلم. So he taught him how to يعني accept Islam, and the father accepted Islam. وجاءت أمه. His mother also came. وزوجته, and his wife likewise came. كذلك يقول لكل واحد منهما كما قال لأبيه وأسلموا. And he told his mother, likewise his wife, the same statement he told his what? His father. And all, both of them accepted Islam. Both of them accepted Islam. So therefore, to show you, barakallahu feekum, alhamdulillah, being around the people of deen, it is important. Look, they heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As the homework that we did, and I had only 4 people that did it, out of maybe 20 brothers. So the statement of here, Jubair ibn Mut'im, he mentioned that kada qalbi an yatir, that my heart was as if my heart was about to fly when he heard this statement recited by the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, am khuliqu min ghayri shay'in am humul khaliqun, that were they created without no deity, meaning no one created them with nothing, or themselves they created themselves, am khalaqu as-samawati wal-ard بل لا يقنون, or did they think that they created the heaven and the earth, but they don't have no yaqeen in their faith. You say, by way of knowing the dungs of the camel, indicating what? That the camel are here. And likewise, the footsteps, the footprints, shows that there is either somebody passing by or there is someone around. So he say, أَلَا يَدُلُّ هَذَا الْكَوْنُ عَلَى اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Now he used these 2 words. He say, أَلَا يَدُلُّ الْكَوْنُ. Don't this universe is a proof for اللطيف الخبير. Right? This Arab didn't use any other names. He used Al-Latif and Al-Khabir. And it's the same word that Barakallahu Fikum, that the father of Luqman mentioned. He say, Ya Bunayya Intakun. Ya Bunayya Intakun. Mithqala. يأتي بها الله يأتي بها الله إن الله لطيف خبير. شوف لطيف خبير. If there is anything from provision في الصخرة في السماوات أو في الأرض يأتي بها الله, that wherever it might be, from the heavens to the earth or underneath in the land and the lake, يأتي بها الله, Allah will bring it forth to you. إن الله لطيف خبير, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the most kind, and He is the one that He is the khabir, He is the one that is all knowing. So look at these words that the Arab mentioned, showing barakallahu feekum, that the word latif shows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being the one that is providing and being generous to His creation, and khabir, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the detail point of His servant. As Ibn Rajab, he mentioned, ta'arraf, al-i'tiraf, ala Allah, it is of how many types? It is of 2 types. Number one, the general meaning, right, knowing that Allah exists. What else? They believe in Allah, and this is the hal of all the believers. Tayyib, the second one,